Assalamu alaikum. A very warm greetings to one and all present here. I'm Maharina Froz, event coordinator of IEEE BBT Women in Engineering Student Branch Affinity and vice chair of IEEE NPSS BBT SB chapter and student of Department of CSE, Bangladesh University of Business and Technology.
And this is Tariqul Islam Rimon, event coordinator of IEEE BUBT Student Branch and the chairperson of IEEE Council on Superconductivity BUBT Student Branch Chapter and student of Department of IEEE Bangladesh University of Business and Technology.
Welcome to our another highlighted webinar. Thank you all for your precious time and attending today's webinar. The webinar is organized jointly by IEEE Sensors Council, IEEE Biometric Council, IEEE NPSS, IEEE Council on Superconductivity BUBT Student Branch Chapter, and IEEE BUBT Women in Engineering Student Branch Affinity. At the initial stage of the event, I would like to request to present the introduction video of the IEEE BUBT Student Branch and its all the chapters and councils. A research problem is a statement about an area of concern, a condition to be improved, a difficulty to be eliminated, or a troubling question that existing in scholarly literature, in theory, or in practice that points to the need of meaningful understanding and deliberate investigations. So today, the honorable speaker of the segment will be Dr. Alvirani Mahapatra. She has more than 17 years of experience in teaching and research. She is working now as assistant professor at KIIT, deemed to be university. She is the reviewer of many journals of repute. I would like to welcome our speaker and request to start her demonstration.
Thank you, everybody, because it is already, I believe, 9:30 or 40 in your time. It is too late for you to listen to me and understand the research problem, identifying the research problem. Let me then briefly, I will just explain what is research, how to identify a research problem, all those things. And what is the time, 30 minutes you have told me, I will definitely close it in that time limit only. Okay, let us start. Let me share my screen and just present my actually I have chosen a topic identifying a research problem because why I have chosen, I thought most of the students are undergraduate students. They are just entering to the phase of research or they will do research in later on. That's why I have to tell something about the key points of identifying a problem and how to start research. And thanks to I have not remembered who has introduced me. Actually, myself, Dr. Oliverani Mahapatra. I am working as assistant professor in School of Electrical Engineering, KIT Dimtumbi University, Bhubaneswar, India. And now coming, first of all, she has also defined the research, but what I have collected, what is the meaning of research from the dictionary, what research means. Actually, many of the, in our day-to-day life, we are also telling through research we can do that. But what is the dictionary meaning of it? It is a serious study of a subject that is intended to discover new facts or test ideas, okay? Or we can say the meaning of research is a careful, systematic, and objective investigation conducted to obtain valid facts, draw conclusions, and establish principle regarding an identifiable problem. This is very important. The problem should be identifiable. That means whatever the research area you have chosen, your problem should be identified, okay? Then coming here, why research is so important? Why all the time we are telling we have to do research? Because whatever the new technology or new products or new whatever the gadgets you are using, it is because of the research. And those are the adding value to our human beings. And this is the aid for nation development. And it is a tool for knowledge building and facilitating learning. It is a mean to understand various issues and try to solve those issues. Whatever the problems human being is facing, by the help of the research, we are eliminating those things. That's why research is very, very important in everybody's life. And you must be knowing, whatever the industry, whatever the IT sector, all the companies, all the organizations, they have a research doing. Because whatever the industry or whatever the organization they are doing, by the help of the research, they are adding value to their product or to their services or whatever they are doing. Okay, that's why it is very, very important. And it is the means to find possible opportunities, what opportunities can be done, how life will be simple, easier. For that, research is very, very important. Also, if you are going for like master degree or postdoctoral degree, after research also, what you have to do, whatever you have got the information, those things you have to disseminate to the outside world. For that, you have to, the skill of writing, analyzing the things, and also you have to read many of the literature to know the state of the art, what you are going to do, okay? That's why research is very, very important in everybody's life or nation development or building any type of knowledge or anything. That's why it is very important. Then this is the most important slide, identifying the research problem, that I wanted to say you. Actually, while pursuing my PhD, one of my professor, he told me the most difficult part of any research is identifying the problem. You have to first know what you are going to do. Without knowing that, no research is possible. And whatever the problem you have identified, that must be a feasible problem. That can, because if you go for a, if it is not a feasible problem, after doing so many work, you will not get any result. That's why you have to first identify the problem, what you are going to do, okay? Once, that's why I have mentioned here, once you ask the right question, if question is correct, obviously, your answer is there. You have an obvious answer for it. But framing the right question, getting the right problem is the most important part of any type of research. Okay? The question you ask implies framing of the problem. Okay? That's why identifying the research problem, whenever you will start the research, you have to first identify what I am going to do. After doing, what is my goal? Whether after doing so many study, whether I will get the information or goal where I want to reach. That's why Research problem identification is the most important part of a research process. Now, what I have mentioned here, characteristic of a great research. Okay, when you have identified the problem, let you have identified the problem, you have a great idea, or you have got a research problem, but getting the research problem is not solving your research process. That's why first you have to know what are the methodology, what are the process, or what is the execution techniques, or what are the tools you can use to reach to the goal. That's why after getting the research problem, you have aware of the execution process, by using which tool. Because if I will say, because I am basically electrical engineer, and electrical engineers mostly they are using different types of tools. Like most important tool for research used by us is MATLAB. Most of the students must be knowing it, MATLAB. Yes or no? MATLAB is known to all of you or not?
Yes.
Yes. Similarly, multi-SIM, P-SIM, who are doing in power system, OpenDSS, many types of tools are there. By using those tools only you can reach to the before going for hardware implementation, you have to go for simulation. For that, different softwares are available. PowerWorld, okay? These are many types of LabVIEW, similarly MyPower, many types of tools are there. By using those tools, you can reach to the goal, okay? Then first you should have a great idea, or you have a research problem. Then by means of tools and techniques, you have to reach to the goal. Okay, then after getting the result, because whatever the result we have got, that should not be limited to our university or our department. That should be disseminated to the whole globe, because in every part of the globe, people are working, and they should know what is the state of the art. That's why whatever the research outcome you got, that should be published. Okay, where you will publish? These research articles you have to publish in many journals, many conferences, many workshops, or also UG projects also you are writing. Those students are in fifth or sixth semester, they have started their research and they will do the UG project. Similarly, master degree students are master thesis, they have to write and they have to submit. Similarly, PhD thesis, project proposals or patents, okay? These are the where you can publish your research outcomes. Okay. Now, from where I will get my research problem? I have told you identifying the problem is the most important part of the research. But how I will get that research problem? It is nowhere written, any book or anywhere. Have you seen anywhere the research problems has been written? Anyone can please answer me? Have you seen anywhere the research problem is written in any book or any syllabus anywhere?
No, we haven't.
You don't have. That's why how I'll get the research problem? For that, I have to go for extensive literature survey. Okay. And where I will get the literatures? From IEEE, from different types of journals. I do not know how many students are acquainted or familiar to conferences and journals, or from those platform I will collect different types of research articles and I will do the research. Before starting the research, I have to go for literature survey, because I should know what people they have already done, what different researchers they have already done, and from that only I will acquire knowledge, and I will get the knowledge of what people they have done, and from what value I can add to it, so that I will get a new result. Okay, that's why extensive literature survey I have given here. Then attending workshops, conferences, technical talks, refresher courses, webinars, seminars, etc. Okay, you have to attend these workshops, conferences, technical talks, refresher courses, so that you can get an idea where you have interest. If you are electrical engineer, if you have interest in power system, you can attend it related to those area, different workshops, different conferences. If you are a computer science students, accordingly you have to attend according to your area of interest, you have to attend different conferences. And also sometimes from your peers who are working with you or who are studying with you, they will also get some information to you so that you can get some research problems from peers groups. Similarly, like UG students, you are attending different tech fest, you are doing some collaborative research, and you will get that research problem from it. Another also I have mentioned, the most important, I do not know how many students are aware of these keywords: ResearchGate, Google Scholar, Scopus, Web of Science, Power Globe, and different social media platforms. Are you aware of these things, students? ResearchGate, Google Scholar, Scopus, Web of Science?
We are familiar with some of them, or some are new.
This Google Scholar is, I believe, familiar to all of you, Google Scholar.
Yes, ma'am.
And this ResearchGate?
Many of us know and many are don't know about this.
Okay. When actually you are in undergraduate level, when you will go for postgraduate and your doctoral research, at that time these are important platform where you can get the your research articles. And you know about the authors, you know about all areas where people are working, okay? Then whenever you are writing any, whenever you are doing research, first thing I have told you, step one, formulate your problem. You have identified your problem. Then do extensive literature survey. Then check the research gap. Very, very important is the step three. Because whatever the literature you have studied, from there you get the idea what is the gap, what people they have already done, and where I can contribute so that it will add value to the research. That's why you have to check the research gap. Then focus and refine your problem. According to the gap, you have to redefine your problem. Explore different research tools. Just now I was telling, different research tools are there. You have to explore them so that using those tools, you can reach to the goal. Then select your tool and begin your work. If you are get stuck at anywhere, try to get help from your supervisor, because all the time whenever you are doing your BTEC project, at that time you have assigned with a research guide, or you have the supervisor during master thesis, during doctoral thesis also, all the time the student is attached with a supervisor. That's why you need to get help from your supervisor. Also sometimes, because whenever you are doing your research in a laboratory, many students are also sitting with you. You get help from them so that you can get the information or knowledge from them so that you can go ahead. Then steps to doing research. If you, I do not know how many students they have started research. These are the extensive literature survey is the first part, because you have to doing that only identify your problem. Then you set your objectives. What exactly you want to achieve? What is your objective? That is the second part. Then whatever the according to the objectives, you have to build the model, or you have to describe your system. Okay, like I am working with solar photovoltaic system, I should know where I can contribute the parameters of the PV panel, or I can contribute to the maximum power point tracker, or I can use any type of multi-level inverter I can incorporate to the system, and I can increase the efficiency of the system of a RA or anything, whatever I am doing. Then you do the simulation, okay, using the tools. Then after that, whatever the simulation, because it is virtual, that's why by help of hardware implementation, you can see whether what results you have got through simulation, whether the same result you are getting in hardware implementation or not. Then after that, whatever the results you got, you do the analysis of the results, whether you are getting the right result, whether the results are acceptable or not. then do the discussion. That means whatever the results you got, you just describe those results so that whenever any other researcher will follow your article, he can understand, he or she can understand what my fellow researcher has already opted and where I and what is the gap where I can add value so that I can go ahead. Then what is the future score and conclusion. Okay, this is the steps of doing research. The same thing I have written here. First, identify the problem, review the literature, then setting research questions. Okay, then choosing the case study or deciding on a sample design, collecting data, processing and analyzing data, writing the report. These are the finally you are writing the BTEC report, BTEC thesis, BTEC project report, or master thesis report, or doctoral thesis report, or you are publishing the research article in different conferences and different journals. Then whoever doing the research, okay, you have great idea, you have the execution process, and you are doing the research. But any researcher have these characteristics or skills and habits to do the research, because finding a new things is very, very important, because it needs lots of hard work. That's why whoever doing the research, he has open mind to learn new things, ready to do hard work, because without that it is not possible to reach to the goal. Then objective should be clear, because that I have already told you, your whatever the problems you have identified, that should be clear to you. Then you should have positive attitude, because whenever you are doing some simulation or whenever you are building the model, many times you will not reach to the result. Whatever expected you are not getting. That's why you have always the in midway many failures you will face. That's why you have the positive attitude to learn the things again and again. Creativity and innovations, ethical values, and efficient time management, because it is very, very important. Because if you have allotted for master thesis, it is only 1 hour, 1 year duration. In that 1 year, you have to complete your thesis. You have to simulate, identify the problem, simulate. Then if hardware implementation is required, do that. Then write the thesis, and whatever the outcomes you need to publish, because many university, they are giving this target to the students, go for 2 conferences publication or 1 Scopus Index journal publication or whatever the university is needing for you, you have to do that. Similarly, in PhD thesis also, in 3 years or 4 years, you have to wind it up. That's why efficient time management is very, very important. Then now, actually, I have given this few things. I don't know how much time is there for me. How much time is there, or should I wind up here?
Ma'am, you can continue.
Okay. You see, I was telling different platform in IEEE papers you want to study, then like in IEEE, you have to go for a search, enter the keyword here. So after I am working on a PVRA configuration, I will put my keywords so that I can get the papers related to that, and I will start my work. Similarly, here also I have given one example, same PVRA configuration, but in Science Direct, I have to search, and these are the research articles that will come here, and according to my requirement, I will download and I will study. Okay. Similarly, whatever here you see, I have given the keyword PVRA configuration here. I can also, those students, they want to do the search, they can go for search and they can type there, and so that these are the research article will come, and they will just download, view PDF if it is, because if your university have the subscription, then you will get those papers, you can download. Otherwise, it is not downloaded. You can take permission from the journal, or you can buy from. This is the conventional advanced PVRA configuration. You see, after getting this journal paper, it is also here some recommended articles also we are here. It is showing. That means related to your search, the journal suggesting some articles related to that also you can do. And here I have given the Google Scholar search profile of myself only. I have searched in Google Scholar my name, so that you can actually I can show that to you also. Let here I was telling this is IEEE. Okay, you see what do you do? You see, you have to advance search. I have given the advances here, PVRA configuration, then search here. Okay, and you have to choose the range of year, in which year. Let I want the recent papers, then I will go for here, go here, and I will search. After search, you will see these are the papers coming. And if it is if you have the subscription, you can download these papers. Otherwise, you cannot. Similarly, in Science Direct also, you see I have given here PVRA configuration. Then search here. Here you can some articles it is recommending. Similarly, this article I want to search. This is the paper. You can get this, download these papers. Okay. What is the highlight of the paper? What is the abstract of the full paper? Also, you can download. Like that, IEEE also I have given, because we don't have that much time to explain all those things. Then coming here. Okay, and Google Scholar. Oh, sorry, Google Scholar. Here you see. I'll type your Google Scholar. Then you let me type my name. Then you see these are the papers according to my the citation. That means how many times this paper has been cited, like that. Here, if you want to, like here also you can search in year wise. In 2021, how many papers published? 2020, like that. In different years, you can see the papers. Similarly, another platform is called Scopus. Here I have already searched. Okay, let me do it for you. Scopus. Then you see author you have to search. Let you are searching for me, Mohapatra. It's the last name. Then you search the first name. Then search it. Then you will find these are the 28 documents, and H index is another indexing. That means how many times your paper has been cited. If it is 10, means 10 number of papers has been cited minimum 10 times. Okay, these, then you will find what is the documents by author, how many citations, okay, what is the H index, all those things, and each paper how many times cited. And here you see cited by highest. You can also cited by new date, newest, like that. You can also search. What is the 20 paper, 21 paper, those things also you can search. Okay, these are the different search techniques coming here. Okay, this is the Google Scholar. That from that only I have given a sample here, how to search, and already I have shown you. The next is your Scopus. Already I have told you Scopus author details. In that also you can the facility of only seeing the journals, only seeing the conferences, all those things also you can do. Okay, when you will go for research, then you will get this information, whatever I have told. Then I have given a case study here. This is the last slide where I want to explain. Let a system, I have identified the problem. Okay, I want to do the increasing the efficiency of a PP system. But after getting the research problem, I have built the model. This is my system. Okay, it has a PP module. It has a converter or load connected to it. And where I want to contribute? Because if I want to do my PhD work, I have to contribute. Minimum three contributions should be there, or minimum three. Three to five, six, any contribution you can do. Then you have to identify where I can contribute. Here one, here I have written accurate modeling of PV module. That already this is my work actually, where I have done the research work to estimate the parameters of PV module, precise estimation of PV module parameters. Then matching of electrical characteristic with experimental data. That means whatever the parameters you have estimated, whether those parameters are right or wrong, that I have to identify by matching the electrical characteristic with the experimental data. Similarly, another contribution is design a MPPT, maximum power point tracking design. Okay, that means how you can operate. If I do not know how many students they are aware of the PV characteristics, because it has a single maximum power point. So that how to reach to the maximum power point by help of a MPPT controller, this is the basic objective of this work, MPPT design under a uniform irradiation condition. And also here another chapter or another work or contribution, I can say, array reconfiguration and MPPT design under partial shading condition. That means whoever actually aware of this area, they can understand if there is a partial shading, because if PV module, many PV modules are connected, because single PV module, the power rating is very low. It is not sufficient for any type of application. That's why PV array is required instead of PV module. And at the time of PV array, like many PV modules are connected, then it is making an array. And when there is a shading or any type of a tree shade or building shade or any type of shading occurring, the characteristic is changing. At that time, how to mitigate those effects and how to enhance the efficiency of the PV system or PV array at the time of partial shading, that is one different works has already been done. These are the PhD work of mine. I am not going detail into it. Okay, thank you. I don't know whether because they are undergraduate students and it is a late hour, I do not know how many of you has understood what I have told. I believe some students who are interested in research, they can definitely get benefit out of it, because early days of research you should know what are the platforms available so that you can start your research. Because if I want to do research in any area, I should know what are the research articles available. That's why where I will get the research articles. That's why it is very, very important. I believe we have already crossed the timeline.
Thank you, ma'am, for your elegant session, which is quite informative. Also so interactive and helpful to know more about identifying a research problem. Now, I'd like to ask for presenting the token of appreciation for our honorable speaker, Dr. Alivarani Mohapatra. Ma'am, please accept this appreciation.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you to all coordinators who is doing this. Thank you, everyone.
Ma'am. Thank you for joining us today. Hope you found the sessions informative, motivating, and engaging. Now yes. That it will be the end of the today's session. Thank you once again to all the honorable guests, faculty members, and students for your cooperations. That is a must for all time. It has been a pleasure being with all of you today. And again, thank you for your patience. However, we have reached to the ending moment of the webinar. I wish your participation in our next events. Stay safe and stay sound. Till then, good night.
Good night, everyone. Thank you, everyone.